Hello everyone. So let us start with a new chapter. We were going to cover the chapter 12, which is about human resources. Now in this chapter, we are going to look at human resource. Then we are going to look at the population, like about the population, what is a population, how change take place, why changes in population take place, what is the vision of government of Rajasthan with respect to population, and what are the problems associated with population change. So let's start. Now, initially we will look at the human resources. So, what is a human resource? Now, human resource is when a person is equipped with skills, is in good health, and performs duties like work. So human resource is when a, human resource is what? It is a person. So human resource is a person. A person, when a person is having good health, when a person is having skill, when he is able to work, we call that person as a human resource. So when a person is equipped with skills, when he is in good health, or when he is and when he is performing his work, we will call it the such person as human resources. Okay. Now, after knowing about the human resource, so example can be IT professional, person working in IT sector, person working in banking sector, or labors. Why labors? Labors also have certain skills. So they also come under human resource. So this is about human resource. Now, after covering about human resources, we are going to look at population. So when we look at population, so population is number of people living in a particular area during a particular time period. So this is about the population. So this is the definition of population. So this tells us that if a particular area is there, how many people live there. For example, as per census 2011, population of India is 121 crore, which means that as per census, so as per 2011 census, in India, 121 crore people were living. So that was population of India. Now, this is about the population. Now, when you look at the census document, this document is the official document of enumeration of people. So census includes the name of all those persons who are living in India. Okay, so it is the official document of enumeration of people, or enumeration of residents basically, or you can say the population or the people who live. So it is enumeration means entering the name. It includes the names of such persons, the official document of enumeration of people living in a particular year. Now this census is conducted every 10 years. So every 10 years the census is conducted. So the next census, so last was conducted in 2011, next is going to get conducted in 2021, okay, which means in the next year a document will be published on the census 2021. Now when you look at the population of a particular country, when you look at the population, you look at various important things, as well as the census document provides certain information about the country's population. So first is size, distribution and density. So let us look at all of these. So when you look at the size means like 121 crore population. So it tells us what is the population size. Distribution means how population is distributed. So population distribution means in particular state in India, how much population is there. Suppose in Rajasthan, population is 7 crore. And say in UP, population is 20 crore. So you can see that in one state population is high, in other state population is less. This is distribution of population. Density. Now, population density means number of people divided by total area. So population density tells us that in a particular area, how many people are living. So this is calculated in persons per square kilometer. So persons per square kilometer. So how many people live in a particular place. So for instance in India, the population density is 382 people per square kilometer. So which means that in per square kilometer only 382 people live in India. But this varies. For example, Bihar population density is high, it is 1116. Okay, now when you look at the size of population, then UP has highest population, whereas Sikkim has least population. Second is population growth and population change. Population growth means, suppose population was 121 crore in 2011. In 2021, population increased to 130 crore. So there is a change of 9 crore in the population. That will be known as population growth or population change. How much population changed? Population changed by 9 crore. Population growth is the change in the growth, change in the population of a country, and this population growth is checked or it is calculated for every 10 years. Okay, so we call it as decadal growth. Okay, we call it as decadal growth. Now, suppose there are countries whose population growth rate is high, low. For instance, India's population growth rate is 17%. Russia's is, now if you take the case of Russia, population growth rate is in minus. Their population growth rate is in minus. The last topic is qualities and the characteristics of the population. So what is the qualities and characteristics? When you look at the qualities and characteristics, we look at literacy rate, sex ratio, oldest population, etc. In literacy rate, we look at how many people, how many are educated, यानी कितने लोग पढ़े लिखे. Now literacy rate is calculated as, the definition is, any person who is above 7 years of age and is able to read, write, learn or understand a language is known as a literate. So this is the literacy rate. So literacy rate of India is 74%. We also look at longevity. Now second is sex ratio. Sex ratio tells us number of male per 1000 female. So in India 950 females are there for 1000 men. Then we look at old age population, which means that how many people are above 60 years in the country. Longevity means average lifespan of people. Lifespan means what is the average year a person is going to live in a particular country. India's longevity is 20 years. So which means that in India a person can live for at least 70 years, whereas for Japan it is 87 years, which means that in Japan a person can live for at least 87 years. So for today only this much is left. In the next class we are going to cover further more topics like why population change take place. So in population change we are going to look at why it changes, like what are the reasons, like birth rate, death rate, migration or mortality. Mortality is nothing. Mortality means when a person dies, okay, or when a person has certain diseases and because of that his lifespan decreases, okay. Now you might have heard about infant mortality rate, etc. So that comes under mortality, which means how many children are dying, why people are dying from what disease, etc. So this is about today's class. In the next class, we'll cover the furthermore topic and we will be done with this chapter. Thank you.